My name's Jeff Baldwin. Welcome back to RE/MAX TV. Today we're talking to a new entrant or a recent entrant to real estate, and her name is Jackie von Horsten. Hi, Jackie.
Hi, Jeff.
Tell us about your first 2 months in real estate. How's that been for you? A big learning curve?
A huge learning curve, but more than the most I've learned actually at this stage in the last 2 months is basically that to believe in yourself. And I first thought that I wouldn't be able to achieve and wouldn't be able to do anything. And through Jeff's wonderful training, I've really learned to believe in myself and take forward what I've learned and apply it.
Well, how many sales and listings have you achieved in the first 2 months, Jackie?
Four sales, and we have 3 listings presently.
So do you think there might be a future for you in real estate?
Most definitely. Definitely going to be moving forward and achieving more and more in a very short time.
We've been working fairly closely together since you've come into real estate, having had a friendship before that through the family. Not only did you have the challenge of being freshly into real estate, but also another one, and that is you've come freshly into Australia pretty recently as well.
Yes.
Tell us about that. That must have been a real challenge for you, coming into a new country from South Africa.
It hasn't been a challenge, if I can put it that way. It's been an absolute adventure, if I can put it that way. And I see it an absolute privilege to be in Australia. It's a new future for us as a family and a new future for me in a brand new career.
Yeah, and you've got a couple of beautiful little girls and a husband to look after as well. So how are you finding that with the RE/MAX system? Are you able to fit that in?
Most definitely. Time is actually flexible, and I try and make my appointments around the time that I have available to myself, and to try and fit it in with the clients as best as possible.
And you're going through our system of being helped along by senior people. Are you finding that there's enough sharing in RE/MAX for you to benefit from those other people that have that more experience to you?
To be honest, I would not have achieved what I have so far if it wasn't for the help of the guys in the office with me and from you as well. I have achieved only due to what they have actually passed on to me. If I never ever need any help, have a question or anything, they're more than willing to just share with me and set aside whatever they're doing and just show me what needs to be done.
Yeah, you know, I found over the years, Jackie, that there's plenty of people that you go out to help, new people in real estate, and one of the challenges is that new people tend to think that it's like the reinvention of the wheel. The wheel can only be invented once, and so many times people have to learn that something doesn't work before they'll not do it. And one of the frustrations I've had as a leader in real estate is to see somebody go out and do something that's not going to work, but know that they have to do it to find out for themselves. It's like kids that, you know, don't think the stove's hot, but until they actually touch it, and then they learn the lesson not to do it again. So what the wonderful, refreshing thing I find with you is that if I say to you, or if one of the senior guys say to you, or more experienced people say, don't do it that way, do it this way, you do the sums very quickly and say, well, you're successful, I think I'll do it the way you're doing it. And, you know, I really admire that. And you know,
you.
From your point of view, obviously that's working for you.
Oh, yeah, it's definitely working. And I have been privileged to be part of Jeff Baldwin's sales success team, and came in halfway through the training because I only started in the 1st of April. And by being part of this wonderful training group, I have just been able to rub shoulders with some of the top performers in the company and just been able to reflect on everything Jeff has taught and put it into practice, and it's definitely working out.
Yeah, from that point of view, you've even seen yourself that some people actually grab it and run with it, don't they?
Oh, yes.
And do the things, and they're very diligent, and others just pay it lip service and expect it to happen. It's like it doesn't happen by osmosis, does it?
No. Another big thing that you think when you come into real estate that it's really hard work and it's going to be really hard to achieve, but if you just put your mind to it and follow the simple process, and Gary always says to me, if you find a buyer and you find a seller and you match them together, you've got business.
That's pretty much it, you know, and sometimes people focus so much on the other way around as well, don't they? They think I've got to find the seller and then find the buyer, and it's pretty much even Stevens, you know. If you can find a buyer, and rather than you're taking the old conventional approach and say, okay, look, I'm going to work really hard with you to find you a house, and then use that as an opportunity to help people to sell their house. You know, it's just really a matter of putting that package together, and you're learning that. And you know, I really admire the progress that you've made in such a short period of time.
Thank you. I think also one of the things I've realised, you think sales is just about selling something, and it's not about that at all. It's about really building a relationship with someone. And when you go around to do an appraisal, it's not about taking a clipboard and walking around the house and writing down what you think is perhaps the features.
That's true.
But just sitting down and letting them feel comfortable with you. Yeah. And I found that you get a much better, a positive response from your clients.
I mean, so often, Jackie, people ask you to appraise their house, but I often say to people, it's very difficult for a real estate agent to tell you exactly what your house is worth because we're not writing the check.
Yes.
It's really about somebody coming in and falling. It's an emotional decision. You know, if someone is emotionally involved with your property, then they'll pay whatever it takes to, within reason, of course, to live in that house.
Yes.
But when you're selling someone's house, it's a matter of not walking around the house and telling them what they already know about it anyway. You know, it's got an air conditioner and skirting boards and this, that and the other. It's a matter of saying, okay, the house is there. First of all, let's form the relationship and gain that trust with one another.
Yes.
and work out whether we're comfortable working together. And that's a two-way thing, isn't it? It's not just about the people. And once you've established that, you can then sit down and work out a strategy, taking the value of their experience in owning the home and putting that together with your knowledge and experience in real estate. And, you know, it's a recipe. We don't know that house as well as they do. They've been living in it for years. And, you know, form a relationship, sit down, work out a strategy, and guess what? You know, if you do that, the results can be terrific. And by forming those relationships and taking them seriously, of course, you also have the value of that person referring their friends and relatives and associates to you. So look, I thank you for coming on to RE/MAX TV today. I know you're a little bit nervous about it initially, and I put you on the spot because we had somebody else not turn up. So having said that, I don't think we could have got a better person to interview. I mean, 2 months in the industry, you've already got a stack of sales and listings, and you've got an enormous future. So Jackie, thank you very much, and I look forward personally to working with you in the years to come and enjoying those successes that you enjoy. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us once again on RE/MAX TV.